drop a like and do share. Leave your comments and do not forget to subscribe for more videos.
What's up, guys? This is Manoj Subtani. I welcome you all on behalf of the Edupedia world. So, we have already completed 5 of our presentations on which I did discuss with you some of the relevant topics relating to investigation and due diligence. This is the 6th video presentation in which I'll be covering the remaining topics which will be pertaining towards investigation. And in the same video, this presentation, I'm going to start one of the exciting topics, that was due diligence. So you'll get to know about the few basic things about what does due diligence actually mean and how do we usually proceed while we go for any entity's due diligence. Fasten up your seatbelts, we are about to take off with the first topic of the day, and that will be short note on investigation in the context of profit or financial forecast report. So guys, first thing is very much first. Think about situations. Okay, before I must tell you something on investigation's point of view, you need to first of all analyze why and under what kind of situations usually the profit and the financial forecast reports can be required. Number one, that will be the general investigation. So, some kind of general investigation is going on in your company, okay? And as part of that general investigation into the purchase of any kind of business, that is number one. Number two, by banks and the financial institutions with regard to any of the project cash flow. There might be a chances that the bank or the financial institution is still apprehensive and providing you some kind of loan with respect to any of your businesses. So that investigation can be done on behalf of that bank or financial institution with regard to the project cash flow and the profitability state for appraisal of that loan application of the borrowers. So these are some of the major situations which usually arise the importance and the need of investigation in the context of profit and financial forecast report. I hope I am clear with that particular stuff. Cool. Now, let's talk about the nature. What's the nature in that particular case? So, number one, all the forecasts depends on the nature of the business. With its numerous and substantial uncertainty, forecasts of profits are not capable of verification by the investigators in the same way as the financial statements of completed accounting period. Number one, that is substantial uncertainty. Number two, special review. So the investigation into profit and financial forecast involves some kind of special review as they depart from the traditional rule of expressing an opinion in relation to the past events. This is something which you are doing on future. Number three will be that greater reliance. So banks and the lending financial institutions place usually, guys, a very great reliance on the profit and financial forecast statements. After all, this is something which is extremely important for them to know. Okay, what's the profitability analysis and what should be your future performance? That they can only judge on behalf of that financial forecast statement that's being provided to the banks and the financial institutions when they are prepared and reviewed by qualified investigators or chartered accountants. You guys must have heard about CMA data, credit monitoring data. So that is something which is usually being very common, okay? If in case you want some kind of loan for any of the property or something, if in case you want some kind of loan for any of your business or something, you just need to prepare a thorough and great CMA data in order to convince the banker that yes, you are the right person to whom they can provide loan easily. Perfect, guys. That was about the short note on investigation in the context of profit and financial forecast report, wherein talked about some of the situations wherein this is will be required and how about the nature of the same. I hope I was able to provide you some kind of clarity with respect to this topic as well. Now, let's move to the next part of this, and that will be steps to investigate on behalf of a party entitled to receive royalty. Supposedly, you're a party, okay, and you're entitled to receive some amount of royalty from any other company, okay, and you want to investigate into the matters that whether you'll be able to receive the royalty on time or not, whether you'll be actually receiving the royalty and you can play safe with that or not. So, what should be the steps to investigate on behalf of the party which is being entitled to receive the royalty? Number one, royalty, let's understand first of all, what does royalty actually mean, guys? Royalty is basically a sum which is usually paid for a right. About what? Right to use any kind of patent, copyright, any other stuff which rightfully belongs to another person. Supposedly, Chetan Bhagat is one of the author, okay, and he has written a few n number of books now. By now, he must have got himself tied up with one of the major publishing company. Okay, so now what's going to happen? Each time any of the book on which Chetan Bhagat is an author, with each book getting sold, Chetan Bhagat is going to receive the royalty from that publishing house. That can be 30%, 40%, 80%, anything. Okay, that depends on the kind of agreement which is being done between Chetan Bhagat and that it's his publishing house. But you as an auditor, you need to analyze first of all. Royalty is basically the sum which is usually paid for the right to use any of the patents, copyright, which rightfully belongs to another person. Royalty payment may be received by whom? Owner of a patent, first of all. Next, author of a book. Third, mine scholaries. So all these things, in these particular areas, usually royalty is being received. If you are owner of some of the patents, have you seen the movie Three Idiots? So in the last part, that gentleman, Mr. Amir Khan, had a privilege of having 400 patents. So what's that? He's the owner of that patent. He must be receiving some of the royalty in that particular stuff. While I was talking about Chetan Bhagat, that will be the next example. So if you are an author of any of the book, again, you are supposed to get the royalty from the publishing house. If you are working with mine scholaries, so on the basis of tons of raw material or coal mine, you'll be receiving the royalty. Now, moving on to the condition part. So royalty agreements, basically guys, it may stipulate a situation whereby the owner of any of the rights can order an investigation of the books of accounts of the user of the right in order to confirm the correctness of the royalty computation or payment. There might be a possibility that that person is going to receive the royalty, but there is another person who is still confused with the fact, how were you able to compute that royalty? Let me check out that particular stuff. Can you show it to me? Okay, cool. You can. So that's one of the conditions. Now, what should be your duty as an investigator? Let's talk about one by one each of them. Royalty agreement being number one. You need to study. You need to study the royalty agreement. And then basically you need to note down the important terms and conditions. Then you need to inquire. You need to inquire whether the royalty is basically payable at a very fixed rate or at a sliding scale, that is like floating rate, according to which the rate of royalty basically increases with the quantity or the number of articles sold. So what's their term in that particular case? Number three would be that you need to obtain the detail of the treatment of returns and allowances which are being given to the customers. The party which shall bear the incidental expenses of any of the sale, be it advertisement, legal charges which are incurred on recovery of any of the bad debts, etc. This is again something which is very important. Next will be, you need to verify the number of copies of the books or quantity of the product which can be distributed free or as samples. This, all these things will be like covered under your investigation as an investigator as far as the royalty agreement is concerned. Number two comes production and purchase records. So guys, as far as the production and purchase records are concerned, you need to examine the purchase record of that publisher in case where the books have been purchased from the printers for resale. Okay. Number two, you need to examine the production records. The production records in order to ascertain the actual quantity and the number of production units, whereby on the basis of which royalty is being calculated on the number of articles manufactured. Likewise, production records of mines should also be examined for, let's say, if it's going on quintal basis or if it's going on ton basis. So then again, that is something which you need to inquire as far as your investigation is being concerned with respect to the production and purchase records. Number three is the sale records. So you need to verify the sale invoices. Sale invoices which are relating to the period for which royalty is computed. And you need to check whether some kind of sale return is being deducted or not, if any, when it is permissible under the agreement. Again, you need to reconcile the sales quantity with the opening stock, the number of articles purchased or manufactured less the closing stock. And you need to look into the sale order book, delivery records, stock records, and so on. Examine the dispatch records when the royalty is payable on the basis of quantity dispatched. There might be a chance wherein the quantity which is being dispatched would be more. However, you as a person who is going to receive the royalty, you may not get the right amount of royalty. Then again, you need to take care of it. And lastly, with the royalty statement. So you need to verify the computation of the amount of royalty which is being payable on the basis of the number of articles manufactured or produced or the quantity being sold to them. So guys, these were the steps to investigate on behalf of a party who is entitled to receive the royalty. I hope I was able to make you clear with regard to each and every kind of example that I delivered to you. Shall we proceed further, guys? Let's move towards the next topic, and that will be the most exciting one for this presentation, and that will be what is meant by due diligence in relation to corporate restructuring. We need to describe briefly major verification areas in a due diligence for a proposed merger. This question was asked twice in CA final examination for May 2008 and May 2010. So let's get the point. What does due diligence actually mean? I'll share a story with you guys in order to make you understand this thing. Let's suppose I am willing to purchase a business. Okay, but before purchasing or procuring or acquiring that business, I want to have a very detailed check, completely detailed check, in order to ensure whether the kind of business that I'm going to acquire, or let's say I want to get merged with another entity, or let's say I want to get into a joint venture with any other company. So whether the company who is on the other side of the table, is it really worthwhile? Is it really worthy to acquire, or let's say merge, or get into joint venture with that company or not? So all these questions will be solved if in case you propose activity which is called due diligence. So what does due diligence actually mean? Let's understand that, guys. Due diligence review, basically it basically involves a very careful and a very sincere study of the situations, the demands, the possibility of successful implementation of any of the restructuring plans. What does restructuring actually mean? Corporate restructuring basically includes internal reconstruction. That, let's suppose something is not going on well with the company and the company wants to reconstruct its entire business internally. Okay, so that is one of the corporate structuring part. Next will be the amalgamation. One company gets amalgamated with another company, and then there is spin-offs. One company procures another company who is the larger one as compared to its own size. Then there is divestiture. Divest one of the holdings, major holdings of its company. Then comes mergers, joint ventures, split-offs, hive-offs. These things basically involve the participation of more than one party in a case. So in all these activities, basically due diligence is being done on behalf of all these things to ensure that you are basically thinking it in a correct, appropriate manner, that whether to acquire that business or not. That is something which is very crucial. So guys, what all can be covered under due diligence? Due diligence review basically can be classified into discipline-wise exercises, and that will be very good in order to make you understand this thing. So, what all different kind of due diligence can happen? Commercial and operational due diligence, financial due diligence, tax due diligence, information system due diligence, legal due diligence, environmental due diligence, personal due diligence. Each and every stuff that you are vouching out in your company, be it commercial, financial, taxation, IES, legal, their personal, environmental, all these things are basically being provided with all these advancements. Due diligence can happen for any of the thing, any sort of, be it commercial. If in case of, I'll talk about commercial. So commercial due diligence is basically like performed by the concerned acquirer, who is more into the involving of an evaluation from commercial, strategic and operational perspectives. If I'll talk about something related to financial due diligence, it basically involves the analysis of the books of accounts and other information which is pertaining to financial matters of the entity. It should be performed after the completion of commercial due diligence. Next will be the about tax due diligence. It basically encompasses the tax aspects of the entity. Then comes information systems due diligence. It talks about pertaining to all the computer systems and related matters of the entity. Then legal. If I'll talk about legal, a legal case would be in respect of any of the legal matters, be it pending suits, be it pending cases, or any other related matters. Then comes environmental due diligence. So this particular due diligence is basically about the study of the entity's environment. What all things are available in the entity's environment, okay, that requires some kind of change, or there is something which is going on in the company and the other person is going to acquire them. Is it really worthwhile for him or her to wait in that particular case with respect to the flexibility and adaptiveness of the acquired entity? And finally, moving on to the personal due diligence. So it's basically done to ascertain that the entity's personal, that is personal policies, are in line and can be changed to suit the requirements of restructuring or not. This was all about due diligence, why it's being done, how about the corporate restructuring, and with which different ways it can be classified into discipline-wise exercises. I hope I was able to make you clear with each and every kind of example that I made you available over here. So are you guys really perfect with due diligence? Cool. Let's move towards the next topic. And that will be, what aspects are to be covered in our due diligence review? So guys, this question, since it was asked in various CA final RTPs, and this question has already been asked in a few of the CA final examination as well, this question is extremely important in order to make you understand that what all aspects and areas you can cover up while you move and proceed towards due diligence review. Believe me, a due diligence review process basically encompasses the entire gamut of the working of any kind of organization. So there are a few areas that need to be analyzed very clearly, very carefully in that case. Number one, what's the history of that business? You're going to acquire that business, or you want to get merged with that business. First of all, you need to have an understanding of the history of that business, when it started, what all were the initial products, who all were the persons who were involved in that company. Now, what is the status of that company? Let's talk about, first of all, first thing comes first, that is the history of the business. Next will be the background of the promoters, who all are the promoters of that company, how much share do they have, are they really working towards the beneficial growth of that company, or they are just like working as a system, sleeping promoters over there. So background and standing of the promoters. Next will be the accounting policies and the practices which are followed by the organization. What all different kind of accounting policies and practices are being followed by the organization? Are they really like working on accrual basis of accounting, or are they doing some cash basis accounting, or some other things? So all these things need to be taken care of in accounting policies and practices which are being followed by the organization. Again comes management information system of the entity. So what kind of MIS is being in place in that entity? What kind of ERPs is this entity being using? Then again, this is something which is very crucial. That will be the detail of the management structure. So who all are involved in the management? Okay, how many directors are there? Who all are really responsible to take care of the real final judgments of that company? So that will be covered under the management structure. Then comes the trading results of the past. So is the share of the stock being listed on the stock exchange? If yes, then what usually had been kind of trading results in the past? Whether the company is really working in a good pace, in the best kind of manner, or if the company is going down, down and down. Next will be the asset and liabilities as per the latest balance sheet. So what is the amount of asset? What is the amount of liabilities? What all different aspects are being included in assets and liabilities as per the latest balance sheet? You need to provide in that particular case while you move towards due diligence review. Then comes the current status of IT assessments, including the appeals which are pending. So again, that is something very important. So that basically talks about like what all IT income tax assessments are still pending against the company, whether the company has really done with the remaining kind of assessments or not. What all have been the cash flow patterns now? So how cash flows are being worked, cash flows are being basically worked upon in that particular enterprise. So how cash is going on and coming, cash flow patterns is extremely important while any of the due diligence review. Next comes the brief description of the basic and other commercial activities. What all different kind of businesses your company basically does. The complete understanding of that stuff needs to be taken care of while you proceed towards that brief description of the basic and other commercial activities. Then comes projection of the future possibility, profitability and the financial position. So what are your projections as far as the CME data of your own entity is concerned with relation to future profitability and financial position? And lastly, different other matters that might require a kind of due diligence review. These are the basic things. This is the exhaustive kind of list that is being used while you take care of the aspects which needs to be covered in any of the due diligence review. I hope I was able to make you clear with each and every kind of example over here. All you need to do is now just revise the topics, because that is which is something extremely crucial, and that is going to change your fate completely. Believe me guys, revision is the key. Don't forget that. I'll be concluding my video with a dose of motivation, and that will be, you may be disappointed if you fail, but you are certainly doomed if in case you do not try. Thank you on behalf of the ADPedia world. Keep interacting with our questions, queries in YouTube comment boxes. I will love to answer each one of your queries and advances. Stay connected. That will help us way, 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 way better. If in case you liked our video, do give us a thumbs up. We'll wait for your positive feedbacks as well. Perfect, guys. I'll see you in the next presentation with a lot more exciting topics. Till then, sayonara. God bless. Bye.